Good morning and welcome to the Episcopal Church of St. John the Baptist in Lodi, California. We are glad you are joining us here today online for our Youth and Family Sunday, and we will begin momentarily. Good morning, St. John's. I'm going to invite everyone who is behind the screens to join us in front of the screens. Today is our second time that we are having our Youth and Family Sunday. It is the first Sunday of the month when we will be doing this. And I have a couple of notes about that in just a moment. For those of you who don't know me, my name is the Reverend Betsy McElroy, and I'm glad you're joining us today. The first thing I need to do is offer an apology. On Thursday nights, we have Compline on Zoom, and I was scheduled to lead Compline on Thursday night, and I was ready to go. I told Steve I have Compline tonight, and I forgot. So I apologize to anybody who tried to get online. I now have an alarm set, so this doesn't happen again. So thank you for your grace on that matter. On our closing hymn today, if you go to the back of our bulletin on page 13, this is what is called a cumulative song. And if you think of the 12 days of Christmas, the 12 days of Christmas is a cumulative song where you sing the verse that you're singing and then you go backwards through the verses that you already sang. So you will see this, children go where I send you, how will I send you, I'm gonna send you, and I'm gonna start with five as if we're at five. Five by five, five for the gospel preachers, then we go to four. Five for the gospel preachers, four for the four come a knocking at the door, three for the Hebrew children, two for Paul and Silas, one for the little bitty baby who's born in Bethlehem. Got it? Okay, so that's how that's gonna work. Our dismissal is gonna be a little bit different. For many, many years, I worked with children in the church, and we had a custom of singing a song, Go Now in Peace, at the end, and I taught them the sign language for that very short song. I will be teaching you all the song today and the sign language to go along with it. Part of that is so we all can see each other, is at the end, after our closing song, which was the one I just talked about, we're gonna actually move to the sides. The choir is gonna come in and join us in the sides so that we are all in a round together. And then I'm going to teach you this song. This is a song that we will be using as our dismissal on the first Sundays of the month. So over time, we will get used to this song and the sign language. Today, I'm going to teach it to you. So we will all have a lot of grace with ourselves as we learn this. And I think that is all I have for you today. I am so glad you're here. Let us take a moment, take a deep breath. Let us gather ourselves in this space, here together. And let us let the music prepare us for worship. Welcome. Thank you. have to switch gears here for this. Blessed be the one holy and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, you are always more ready to hear than we to pray, and to give more than we either desire or deserve. Pour upon us the abundance of your mercy, forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and giving us those good things for which we are not worthy to ask, except through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
You may be seated for the reading.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." So out of the ground, the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air, and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was his name. The man gave names to all cattle and to the birds of the air and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man he made into a woman, and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of man this one was taken. Therefore a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh." Hear what the Spirit is saying to all God's creation.
Thanks
be to God.
I will read two aspects of the come after. Our Lord, our Governor, O Lord, our Governor. Out from the mouths of infants and children,
your majesty is gracious of us.
You have set up a stronghold against your adversaries. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers,
the moon and stars set in your courses.
What is man that you should be mindful of him?
The Son of Man that you should be
You have made him but little lower than the angels.
You adorn him with glory and honor.
You give him mastery over the works of your hands.
You put all things under his feet.
All sheep and oxen.
Even the wild beasts of the field.
The birds of the air, the fish of the sea.
And whatsoever the walls of the gods to see.
Our Lord, our Governor.
How exalted is your name in all the
Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Some Pharisees came, and to test him, they asked, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife?" He answered them, "What did Moses command you?" They said, "Moses allowed a man to write a certificate of dismissal and to divorce her." But Jesus said to them, "Because of your hardness of heart, he wrote this commandment for you. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." Then in the house, the disciples asked him again about this matter. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." People were bringing little children to him in order that he might touch them. And the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and bless them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Well, good morning and welcome. And before you all get comfortable and get seated, I could use some small people and some tall people up here at the front to help me. Can I get a couple of small people to help me? Think you could come up here and help me for a moment? No? Okay. Do we have somebody who's willing to pretend to be really short and small?
Yeah. up, he's filling in the tips of your toes and the top of your head. And nobody, anywhere, can ever separate you from that. Amen.
Amen.
Let us rise together and confirm our faith. We believe in one God.
if I just speak with my voice? I think I can just. Okay. I thought I'd have some children here, so Ollie, did you want to come up and help me out a little bit? I have something that we've been sharing in Sunday school. I'm Janie Williams, and I'm one of the Sunday school teachers along with Ruth Diekman and Peggy Lewis. Hi. We've been learning about prayer and ways that we can pray, and so I'm going to have May pull this just can stand right here, just like this, so everybody can see, because we have a very fun and kind of a simple way to help us remember and how to make our own prayers out of our own words. Excuse me. So I'll do the talking. Okay. So anyway, I think we all know and are familiar with the Lord's Prayer, and we're learning to memorize that, of course. But we thought we'd talk about using our own words. And sometimes it's hard to organize our thoughts, so this is just a helpful way to organize our own thoughts. So we're using the letters in pray to help us do that. So, Maeve, can you say P? P stands for praise. Praise God for all his goodness and his love. R stands for remember. We need to remember how God has helped you and to always thank him.
A
stands for ask. Ask God to help others or to keep your family safe or to comfort a friend. And
why?
Y stands for you. Tell God what you wonder about and ask him for what you need. So we know that we should pray every day because God loves you. He loves you very much, and he always wants to hear what you are thinking about. So hope this helps you. Amen. Thank you.
God, who is always with us, we pray for healthy food to eat, beautiful music that moves us, relationships that bond us. We pray for friends and grown-ups and for the gift of listening. Thank you for all these ways to care for each other and inspire us to continue to share in your love.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed,
by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name.
Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us greet one another with a sign of God's peace.
Thank you. agree with you there.
Salvation Army, etc. So at the heart of it, we need to voice our opinions and have our presence. Tomorrow at 4, if you can be there, it would be fabulous. Part of it is just a learning process. I don't know all the bits and pieces myself, but I have been reading the Sentinel and things, and so I have somewhat of a semblance that things are a little bit like this, and so it'd be nice to get a handle on things to come. So in addition to Sunday service, Betsy mentioned that we are doing a Thursday evening Compline by Zoom. And if you go to page 15, you will see the link there. Penny also sends it out during a weekly update email. And then, of course, our noonday prayer up in the chapel on Wednesday mornings. Also, we have an incredible fundraiser coming up on Saturday, October 26th. It is Slaying at the Speakeasy. We've not done this. This is a murder mystery dinner. You don't have to dress up, but you're welcome to. And it is supposed to be spectacular. So there's a great meal planned. Garlic chicken, roasted vegetables, beautiful salad, dessert, etc. And then we will be led through a murder mystery. So come one, come all. Tickets, because it's entertainment and dinner, are $85 per person. We will be available in the coffee hour area selling tickets, but you can also touch base with Penny. There's also, I believe, a online way to purchase it, and that too should be here in your bulletin. Horrific things going on in the Southeast Florida, that whole corridor, including Carolina. So there is a QR code here if you would like to do contributions and help and support the relief efforts in that area. And I'm going to make a plug. Next Sunday, we launch our stewardship campaign, our annual fall pledge campaign for the following year. This week, you should be receiving pledge packets. But I'm also pleased to let you know that on our website, we have an online pledge form. Woohoo! Making it real easy. So when you go to stjohnsoflodi.org, you get to the homepage. Just scroll all the way to the bottom, and you'll see a quick link. Click on that, it's stewardship campaign, and it'll take you right to that particular opening welcoming letter from Betsy, as well as then followed below it with the online pledge form. So, more to come. Wanted to let you know it's on its way. Thank you.
Thank you, Beth. I don't have any additional announcements. You're welcome. So I would like to invite anybody else. I do want to thank for yesterday. Sorry, I'm going to do an announcement. Yesterday was Pride Day in Stockton, and a number of our folks, especially Brad and Andy, put in a lot of time to get ready for that event, and then a number of our parishioners went down to support that. I want to thank you for being down there and sharing St. John's love. So thank you. Hundred and two, is that what I got up to? Yeah, so thank you all. Birthdays and announcements. Who would like to come up for that?
Hey, old man.
Well, we'll start with the tallest and go to the shortest. How about that? Would you like to go first?
How do you do this?
So, say your name, and then why what you're celebrating.
Well, my name is David, and I'm celebrating my 67th birthday a few days ago.
I didn't come to the point. Oh, we'll do something.
I'm Dick. I saw that. Let's see, 24 cents. 74 birthday.
Oh, exact change. And last but not least?
I'm Jack Cook, and I'm 89.
Wow. Today we're also thinking of Deacon Tom and Henny, who are traveling right now in Ireland. So that is also, we are grateful that they have that time to spend together and pray that they will be safe. Our prayer for birthdays, anniversaries, and Thanksgivings is on page 9. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them as they stand. Comfort them when discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up if they fall. And in their hearts may your peace, which passes understanding, abide all the days of their lives through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Happy birthday to all of you.
You can see what happens. He's the youngest, he's the tallest. You're the next shortest.
Let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
to deliver us from the power of sin and death, and to reveal the riches of your grace, you looked with favor upon Mary, your willing servant, that she might conceive and bear a son, Jesus, the Holy Child of God. Living among us, Jesus loved us. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, healed the sick, and proclaimed good news to the poor. He yearns to draw all the world to himself, yet we were heedless of his call to walk in love. Then the time came for him to complete upon the cross the sacrifice of his life and to be glorified by you. On the night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with his friends. He took bread, gave thanks to you, broke it, and gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper was ending, Jesus took a cup of wine. Again, he gave thanks to you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink of it, do this in remembrance of me." Now gathered at your table, O God of creation, and remembering Christ crucified and risen, who was and is to come, we offer you our gifts of bread and wine, and ourselves a living sacrifice. Pour out your Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the body and blood of Christ. Breathe your Spirit over the whole earth and make us your new creation, the body of Christ given for the world you have made. In the fullness of time, bring us with St. John and all your saints from every tribe and language and people and nation to feast at the banquet prepared from the foundation of the world.
Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever. Amen.
Now, as our Savior Jesus Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
We do our duty with one another, for we all share in one another.
Thank you.
here. Today we will be having one station in the center for bread, but then you can split to your side for the wine. We do not dip the bread into the wine here at St. John's. We sip from the cup. If that is not your preference, you may cross your chest and we will know that preference and you will still receive the blessing over the wine. If you do not want communion but would like to come forward for a blessing, please come forward, cross yourselves, and we will know your preference. The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. We do also have gluten-free, if that is something that you need. Come to the side of me and grab that yourselves so that I don't touch it.
Thank you.
Let us rise in body or spirit. And let us pray. God of abundance,
give us the bread of life and heart of salvation. Give us the grace of Christ.
God, you like this? God, can remember the words. Surround you. Okay, now we're going to tip our knuckles. Swipe, swipe. Everywhere, like TikTok. Everywhere you may. And then we do our go. So, we will learn this. We'll do this twice in a row. We'll sing it slowly so you can catch on. But by the end of the year, we'll have this done.
Okay. I hope it's
winding up. Okay.